Artboards are what I would consider as a top-level organizational element, and they make complete sense if you're working on a project to include all of the elements of your project inside of one file rather than having to port around several different files. So in here, I've got some fairly simple elements for the purpose of instruction, a few different artboards down here containing different elements for an exhibition. Then I've got the front of an exhibition pass here, the back of an exhibition pass. This is ready for something like Instagram, and this would be ready for a 1080p element just there. Now, if I use the shortcut command 0, that takes me to the current artboard. Option command or Alt Control 0 takes you out to all of the artboards. Now, there is a tool to manage and create and delete your artboards. You access it with the shortcut Shift O. Okay, that takes you to the artboard tool, or it's down at the bottom of the toolbox just here. And with that, you can select your artboards should you need to do so. You can move your artboards around. Now, notice here that the artwork has moved along with the artboard most of the time, exactly what you want. And that's because of this small button here in the control strip. If I go ahead and select this artboard again and turn that off, I can then move the artboard like so, and the artwork just sits out here on the pasteboard. And it may be that you want to do that if you're using the Alt or Option key to drag a new copy of the artboard. They can all be named, and indeed should be named. It helps to do that. You can see here that I've got header BG there, event title, header BG fade, pass front, pass back, artboard 5, which needs a name. So I'll click on that and give it a name. So I'm just going to call this Insta, just here. Insta 1080 is what I should really call it there. There you go. And I'll go to this header BG copy, and I'm going to call this header BG GS for grayscale. It could be whatever you like. And the 1080p already has a name. Okay, I'm going to make sure that I re-enable the move and copy artwork with artboard option there, so I'll forget later on and go to copy something and then, there we are. You can select artboards by either clicking on them and then holding down Shift and clicking on subsequent artboards. You can also drag, but what you have to do first, if I just click away from this, is you have to hold down Shift and click. That tells the artboard tool that you want to drag select. And if I drag across the artboards now, whoops-a-daisy, I forgot to keep hold of the Shift key. So I'm going to hold down Shift and click and then drag like so. And you can see those artboards are selected. Now, new in this version of Illustrator, just so you know, is the ability to copy and paste these between documents. That was a much asked for feature. So you can now do that if you've got something like this, an event set up, and you want to move it onto the next project, just copy and paste to save you doing a save as or reinventing the wheel, as it were. The artboards can be changed in size either by dragging like so. So you can change them this way if you need to, or you can choose from a bunch of preset sizes. For some reason here, mine is drawing off the top of the screen. That's just a bug because this is an early release of this particular version of Illustrator. And you can also enter coordinates, the name. You can go to the artboard options to do some of that stuff as well. And although I can't show it to you because of this glitch with the menu, if you've got some artwork selected in that list right at the very top, of course it would be, is the option to fit the artboard to the selected artwork. There is actually a panel for our artboards, and it should be in the default Essentials layout, but of course, and I'm sure you know this by now, if it's not there, let's say it together, it's in the window menu. There you go. Okay, so here we can see all of our artboards, and this is another reason why naming things is a good idea. We can reorder them from here should we need to do so. So interestingly, that's artboard 5, the one that didn't have a name. I could actually do that right now. So if I call that one Insta 1080 just there and hit return, I've got it. Okay, so I can move those things around as desired. I think I'm going to move that down one from there. And as you just saw, if I double click on something, then it takes me to that particular artboard. So they are a navigational tool as well. Although you can also do that from the bottom of the document area here. And in fact, right at the beginning of the course, we will have actually done that. Okay, so to organize them more cleanly on the pasteboard, if I just view all of them using Option Command 0, that would be Alt Control 0 on Windows. Okay, what I can do is go to the flyout here and choose to rearrange all artboards. I can also click this small icon at the bottom here, and thinking about it, that's actually closer, so we'll do that. Then I can determine how these are going to be laid out. So you can lay them out in rows like so, or columns, or a straight line, either across or down. I think I'll go down with this one in a column. For the spacing here, I'm going to give it a good chunk. So I'm going to give 40 millimeters just here. Move the artwork with the artboard. Yes, please. And hit OK. And there you go. That's all organized. And you'll see it follows the pattern that is in here. So here's the header. And there's the Instagram one just there, the pass front, the pass back, and there you are. That easy to keep your artboards nicely organized.